I'm gonna show you the sequence here. I taught you earlier today, or maybe a couple of days ago, depending when you see this video. So we start sitting between the legs. We lift the ankles up, and I just move my knees open and lean backwards a little bit to get traction, and gently rock the body from side to side. The leaning doesn't need to be so much, just a little leaning, and the rocking doesn't need to be so much, just a little move, and then you can see that how the whole body starts to move. And try to move from your own body when you're rocking. Now it's nice to do this for somewhere between 45 seconds and a minute. And from there, show everything a little bit shorter in this video. You let go, you bring the feet down. Now always observe the ankles. I mean, not in this video, but normally if somebody has ankles like this, maybe I decide to have a pillow on the ankles. Then bring your knees into the arch of the feet, your hands coming into the calves. Just move your body up, pressure comes into the knees and pressure coming to the hands. And then moving ourselves back. So move the hands down, coming up, pressure knees and calves, and moving back. You can go a little bit to lower part of the lower leg, going down, and do one more time. Coming up. And there we're sitting down, we remove the knees. I'm going to turn the feet open. When you turn the feet open, hold the ankles, lean backwards a little bit, and then it's easy to turn the feet open. And I'm going to palm walk the legs. Don't make the steps too small. Also, don't make them too big, of course. Skip the knees and just lean in and move from your body, from right to left side. Be careful not to roll the leg. Just pressing into the center of the hamstrings. And when you're down, you can go a little bit line two, line three, upper legs or lower legs, depending on how the legs of the client are turned. We do one more time, coming up. Feel that you can use the wave of the body to go in, leaning in. Small movements of your body, let it be effective. Don't make the movements too big. Then moving back onto the legs. Now from there, I'm going to bend the left leg, lift the foot up and slide my legs under his body. Make sure you're not too low. Somewhere upper part of the upper leg. The leg opens up more. And now with my left arm, I'm not to use the point of the elbow, I try to use more the flatter part of the elbow. I bring my shoulder in the right position and then lean in into my left arm. If you feel that the leg is too heavy or because hyperextending into the knee, sometimes you can lift the knee or you can hold it. If somebody's heavier legs, the lifting of the knee is better. Going here again, you're leaning in. And going back. Again, you skip the knee, we can press. Leaning in, it's nice also to go to the hip here. So come over more with your body and press. Pressing, relax your hand. Don't lift the arm up, this is more sharper. If you want more pressure, you can do that, but try to relax the arm so it's a less sharp point that's touching. Now something extra what you can do here, that you walk from one to the other, lower leg, upper leg. You just walk your elbows, gently move your body. Now from there we can bend the knee. With my armpit or my leg, I can lock it and lean in. If somebody's more flexible, what you can do, you can lift the leg up, lift the leg up, lift the leg up. Okay, repeat two or three times. I'm letting go, I lift the ankle up again, maybe shake the leg a little bit. Now bring the foot, the hand on the inside of the knee, and bring the foot to the knee. If the foot doesn't want to move, just hold it. Don't press it down, it can be dangerous. Then line yourself up in the line of the upper leg and pressing in into third line outside leg. Going here, it's nice also to press into the buttocks. It even can give a little stretch in the inner hip for some people. And then moving back. And moving back. From there, I move to the other side. Right hand goes to the ankle. I'm stepping, walking around, left foot. Hello, capo. The left foot comes into sacrum or a little bit lower back. Left hand holds. Turn my body to the leg, I bend my knees, straighten my back, and lift the leg towards me. There's no pressure in the left foot. The left foot is just there for support. So I let the left foot go, it goes there. Just holding it, but don't press down to the left foot. Then the left leg goes back. Again, you can repeat a couple of times. You can shake the leg a little bit. Slowly move to the other side, Bootje. And coming here, we do the same on the other side. I do this side a little bit quicker. We lift the leg up, go under, and press. Pressing in. Again, don't make the elbow too sharp. Unless you want more pressure and you don't have enough body weight, you can make the elbow sharp. It's nicer to have more rounder feeling. You can go into the hip. I mean, we didn't do it in the core, even possible sometimes to go into the lower back, to press in into the lower back. But that's also nice too, to walk. To walk with the arms. From lower leg to upper leg. The hand comes into the ankle, my right hand comes down, I can press my body up. Maybe shake the leg a little bit. Bring it a little bit to the outside, hand goes in inside the knee. Bring the foot to the leg. Just holding it, don't pressing here. Pressing in the third line, outside leg. Coming up and move down. Now go to the hip again. Pressing to the buttocks can be nice. Again, you can repeat a couple of times if you would like to do that. Then I move to this side, my left hand finds the ankle. I move, move, move my right foot. Shake my lower back. Bend my knees, no pressure on the right foot, and lift. Lift towards you, lift towards you. Depending on the flexibility of the client, see how far you can go. Then you're, let the left leg go down, maybe shake the legs a little bit. Then let the feet slowly come into the ground, stepping forward and bring your knees onto the buttocks. Less pressure, you just sit down like this. So the pressure just doesn't go much into your knees. When you have more pressure, bring your body weight forward. If you even want more pressure, you can bring your body up completely to here. Sometimes you can even shake a little bit. From there, my left hand goes to shake, my step over to the other side. I'm going to gently rock the body. Your left arm is relaxed, and you gently rock, and the rocking comes from your own body. Now the right hand, I'm going to press straight down in first line. The right hand doesn't move, the right hand just presses. Same here again, right hand presses, left hand rocks. There's no rocking in the right hand, only in the left hand. Go to around here, maybe not high up. And going back, right hand presses in again. And going to the lower back. All the time the rocking stays the same. But if I lean in, the pressure goes in my right hand, not in my left hand. Then go to the second line. Going to, up more. Second line is on the belly of the muscle, the erectus. And my right hand takes the rocking over. I can move to the other side, see if we can keep the rocking. Sometimes if you work on somebody bigger, sometimes I have the right foot stays on the other side. Sometimes it's easy to lean in and go into the first line again. Because George is not that big, I step the right leg back. So press into your left hand, the right hand rocks. So my weight really shifts to my left hand. See where my body goes? Really to the left side. No pressure in the right hand. The right hand, the pressure stays all the time the same. And moving to here, then we go to line two. Come up, press. Keep a nice rocking, nice rhythm. Line two, belly of the muscle. Maybe coming to here, shift my weight. Maybe change my body position a little bit. Now when you stop the rocking, you slowly let it fade. Slowly let it fade out, slowly let it fade out. Now I'm going to sit on each side, the knees on each side, the feet on the inside the legs. Now with my thumbs, I'm going to press the first line. I'm going to have my thumbs facing up. The line one is next to the spine, between the muscle and the spine, I'm pressing straight down. Come up, pressing straight down. Coming up and pressing straight down. Again, use the weight of the body. If you feel the upper part of the back is too far away, sometimes I step my left foot or right foot up to have a better angle to press in. We can go to here and moving back down. And from there we can turn the thumbs to each other, go to the second line, same idea, leaning in. We turn the thumbs because otherwise it's easy to slip off the muscle. The thumbs are like this, it's have better control that you don't start to roll off or slip off the muscle, especially when the muscle is more tight. It's going to here and moving back. And pressing the lower back. And from here, I move the left arm next to his body. Step my right leg over. Bring the arm gently when you lift the arm. Don't lift the arm too finely, maybe first straighten the right leg more. Bring the arm on here, you can feel the resistance. Hands going around the shoulder. Gonna make a circle for the shoulder outwards. And you can make slowly circle a bit bigger. At one point we can hold and make a little twist. Twisting the body, just leaning backwards, twist, twist, twist. The right upper leg sometimes can lock the lower back a little bit, if it feels necessary. Then bring the arm next to the body. Step to the other side. Joe is going to turn his head to the other side. Bring the arm up. Bring it onto the arm. Arm onto the leg, hands around the shoulder, making circles. And again, the circling, everything I do, try to move from your body. It's very different to do this with the arms. If you actually move with your body, moving with your body. Same here, my right knee here. Hands around the shoulder, maybe lock the lower back a little bit. And give a nice twist. From there, this arm can stay here. I take my body up, get this other arm. And bring the arms onto my legs. Now, don't actually sit down. So the weight stays into my feet. And the moment that I can do with my buttocks and can press sacrum, I can press the sacrum back. So the hands coming around the shoulder. Take an in-breath, George. And I will press the sacrum down and lift him up, lift him. If you feel your client is heavy, there's nothing wrong to ask for the first part to let your client help and let him go. So what you can do, George, can you help me for the first part? Take an in-breath, let him help, and then just relax, 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 relax. So especially when you work with more heavier clients, sometimes you need to ask for a little support of your client. You don't want to hurt your back. Then you let it go down. Hand and go with the arms. Maybe arms can go next to the body. Maybe keep in contact. Going to this side here. Now my thumbs, I'm going to work into the shoulders and just pressing in. Just leaning in, double thumb press, and moving back. And we can do it, different spots. If you look at my knees are helping with the pressure. My knees are pressing into the elbows to apply more pressure. For there, my left knee goes down, my right leg steps up. Hands going, you have to shake them here, just at the beginning of the hips. Now don't press the hip bones away with sharp hands. Try to press everything away. So my hands are soft and it's pressing away by leaning in. Maybe my arms can bend more and can press away more. Sometimes I like to rock a little bit, doesn't need to be necessary, just can also hold it. Rocking can be nice to create more space. But there we can let go, bring the hands here and go up a little bit more. So the same technique, pressing away. Don't press actually down, we're pressing away. Hands coming up higher. And pressing away, pressing away. Then bring our hands together. I just make a little of a to finish off. A little of a ticking, a little clicking. Don't make this one too hard. Just nice and soft. The back, lower back, you can be shaking a little bit. And slowly letting go and slowly letting go of the hands. Okay, hopefully it's helpful.